Here are three reasons your chickens have stopped laying eggs. I'm gonna go through them one by one. Let's go.
Welcome to Becky's Homestead.
Happy, healthy hens should lay lots of eggs. So we're going to go through the three things one by one so we can cover them very well and you can understand them. And then you can figure out if you're missing one or two or even all three of them in your coop and you can fix it and then get your chickens laying eggs again. Okay, so let me talk about the first thing is the health part of it. All chickens, especially hens, need grits, they need to be dewormed, and they need calcium. Okay, so the reason they need to be dewormed is the worms will go all through the chicken. There's like different kinds of worms, they call them internal parasites. They will be all through the chickens in different stages. So it's very, very important to deworm your chickens. I'm gonna tell you the telltale sign of your chickens having worms. It's gonna be the eggs come out poopy. That's what I've discovered in the past. If there's poop on the eggs, your chickens need to be dewormed. Healthy chickens should lay eggs. Those eggs should have a little sheen on the shell. They should be clean, and you should look in there and it should just be a pile of shiny, clean eggs. So that's easy to fix. All you have to do is deworm them. I have made other videos talking about how to deworm your chickens naturally, and you can do it the same way I do it, which is an awesome way. The second thing chickens need every single day is grit. They have to use grit to digest their food. So if they don't have grit, yes, the food's gonna still go through them. They're not going to die if they don't have grit. But if you want your chickens to be super healthy and efficient, I mean, who wants to waste feed? Feed is expensive. So you have to give them grit. You can buy bags of grit in the feed stores. Just look for it. And what it is, it's kind of reddish colored granite. It's sharp kind of, and it's crushed up. They will eat that. It gets in their gizzard. Their gizzard is like a muscle and the food gets in there, the grit is in there, and it just like agitates, the gizzard does, and it like grinds up the food. The grit eventually gets worn down and they'll just pass that through with, you know, the food. It'll just go through their system. So they have to keep eating it. You don't just give it to them once and like that's it. So, you know, just make sure it's available all the time because who knows when they need it, how often, every chicken is different. I just make it available all the time. So when they need it, there's no lapse in it. They just eat it and it's always in there. The third thing they need is calcium, especially the hens that are laying eggs. It takes a huge amount of calcium to make the eggshell every day or every other day. And if you're giving it this, those eggs will come out like clockwork. You can just depend on it. So also, the muscles in the back of the hen need the calcium for whatever reason to push that egg out every day. Those muscles need to contract to get the egg down the pike and then to lay the egg. And I also have a video about that as well if you want to learn what exactly happens when they make an egg inside of a chicken. And so it's good to know all this stuff just to help you take better care of them. You can buy bags of crushed oyster shells. And so you just like the grit, just make sure that's always in the coop on the ground in the run, and they'll just pick and scratch and get it when they need it. As long as you provide them those three things health-wise, your chickens will like really be doing good. Like you'll just be on the right road. The second part we're gonna talk about is nutrition. all hens, well, really all chickens, but hens especially because we want to get their delicious eggs, need a lot of animal protein. Chickens are meat eaters. You will see that for yourself if you let them out and they free range. They will head straight for the thick woods and start digging under all the leaves in the woods, looking for bugs, worms, lizards, baby snakes, toads, anything they can get. They love meat. They don't look like it, but they are meat eaters. So what you have to do if you want your chickens to lay regularly, which of course we all do, that's why we have them. So we would like to just keep them going as efficiently as we can, is you have to add animal protein to their diet. Now, I'm gonna tell you some forms of animal protein, and when I say add it to their diet, if you wanna get regular eggs, you have to give it to them every single day. They need some. So even when mine free range, I still add some to their diet. And my chickens are fantastic layers. I get so many eggs. I give dozens and dozens of eggs away from my 8 hens that are laying. Plus I do eat a lot of eggs and I share with my family. Okay, so let me first describe some types of animal protein that you can add to your chicken's diet. The easy ones I'm gonna mention first. So buying bags of mealworms at the feed stores. Tractor Supply, Rural King. I thought I saw those at like a smaller store somewhere. Lowe's, yes, they had a little section. They sold mealworms, which I was surprised. I'm like, hey, look, Lowe's sells mealworms too. So you can find those if you look around. Those are pretty easy to find and they're convenient because they're dried out and you can just grab a handful and just throw it in the run. You don't even have to like have a food bowl or anything. They love to scratch around and get those. So it gives them something to do, which keeps them very happy and it makes it easy peasy for you. Okay, so that's a really easy way to add animal protein to their diet. But other forms can be high quality cat kibble or even like puppy kibble, you know, something that are small pieces. Some dog food has small pieces, but of course some are huge chunks for those big dogs. Chunks that are about the size of a piece of whole corn are perfectly fine. Try to stick with that. And then in the winter months, when there's no bugs anywhere outside for them, you can add like cans of sardines. Sardines are really cheap. It's just little cans of fish. You know, you just peel the top off, put a can in there every day. If you have tons of chickens, like maybe 16 or 20 or even more, some people have even more, obviously you're going to need to add a lot of cans. But for my group, you know, maybe one can a day would be enough. I have the 8 hens and one rooster in there, not counting these little ones. And then so sardines, if you can get them on sale, tuna fish, you know, stock up on that stuff. I'm trying to think of other canned meats, like what else, you know, even like maybe cheap hot dogs, you can cut them up. Table scraps from your table from dinner, all the meats, you can just throw in there to them. Just meat, basically just meat, throw it in there to them. And then that is gonna really help them. And like I said, especially in the winter months, and you will get eggs all winter. So try that one out. Okay, so the third thing we're gonna talk about is the comfort of the chickens, the hens in the hen's house. Specifically in the hen house, they are little divas. You have to treat them like little divas if you want them to be calm, happy, and lay lots of eggs for you. And they will. They'll like just be so happy and healthy and just so adorable to watch and everything if you get it right. If you don't get it right, it can be a nightmare and a disaster. So I'm trying to help you get it right and get things on track. Okay, so now we're gonna talk about the hen house specifically. The hen house has to have a few things very specific in order for the hens to be happy in there, because that's their little, you know, that's where they're gonna lay their eggs. First of all, they have to sleep well. If they're stressed out at night because something's stalking them or they're just too crowded in there, they're not on the roost well, they're just not gonna be happy and healthy. They have to be like up there on that roost, zonked out at night sleeping.
They have to feel safe.
Yeah, they have to feel safe and be comfortable. If they're too crowded, they're not comfortable. So it is comfort and safety. Okay, so the roost, you know, you wanna have it high, like more nervous breeds. like those white leghorns and, you know, like the little silkies. There's a few breeds that are a little more high strung. They like the roost high. And then kind of the calmer hens, you know, they could be on a lower roost. What I do just to solve the problem, because I like a mixture of different breeds, is I make the roost high, but then I build a little chicken ladder, a little chicken ramp ladder, so they can walk up there. That just solves the problem. They're all up kind of high, and there's no problem with the more mellow breeds getting up there.
And they're so cute when they walk up there every night.
So funny and so cute. They're just, it took them a little while to figure it out, because at first they're like looking up, they're like, how are we gonna get way up there? And then it doesn't take them long, you know, hens all cackle like they're talking about it, and then as soon as one starts going up the ramp, they all figure it out. It's adorable. Okay, so make sure they have a roost that's big enough. A lot of people overcrowd their coops. They just, I don't know, just out of like, they're so cute when they go to buy them. They buy too many when they're this big. And it's like, no, when they're grown, they're big and need room. So that is the number one problem people have. If you're having that problem yourself, try and just, you know, cut your flock in half. Maybe just give them away or sell them. Because really, you'll get better egg production from less hens than you will from having too many hens and it's not going well. You're gonna be spending all your money on feed and not getting a return on that.
And everybody's unhappy.
Yes, you're not gonna be satisfied, they're not gonna be happy. It's just it's a disaster. So truthfully, less is more. It's my like life motto here. Okay, so we covered the roost. So put it kind of high, build the little ladder up there, and solid walls are nice so they don't feel stalked by, you know, raccoon come sniffing around or whatever. Secondly, you want to have really nice egg boxes. Keep your egg boxes clean. If you notice a chicken sleeping in there, it could be getting beat up and bullied and it's afraid to get up on the roost. The roost is too crowded. So what you're going to have to do, and maybe it's young and it just doesn't know yet, so maybe gently get it out of the nest box and put it up on the perch a couple times when you go in there
at night.
You don't
want anybody getting picked on. You want everybody getting along.
Absolutely,
harmony.
Yes. That's like awful. But sometimes they just don't know yet. So you're just going to help it, put it up there, and it'll be like, oh, I'm up here now. Like, it'll figure it out and get up there the next night. If it continues, it's probably getting picked on. And so you're going to have to figure out who is the bully and get rid of the bully maybe, or have less chickens in there so they all have room to get away from each other. All right, so you're gonna have your nest boxes, and the bottom of the nest box, you can have like 2 feet off the ground. That's kind of a good, or lower, like don't have them too high. A lot of times if you put a little strip of wood right at the beginning so they can jump up there and have something to grab onto and it's not slippery, they'll just jump up there to the nest boxes. If their little feet slip, it makes them a little insecure, and they might start just laying their eggs on the ground in the coop
somewhere.
Chickens
like sure footing at all times.
Yeah, they do.
They don't like walking on ice. Don't ever take your chicken ice skating.
Otherwise, it's going to be, whoa, when it's getting up there to lay an egg. And don't forget, the egg's going to be like right there ready to come out. So it doesn't want to be like slipping around like, whoa, you know, and it's like gentle. It just wants to get up there in the nest and lay an egg. Also, make sure your nest boxes are clean, clean, clean. If you haven't cleaned your coop in like, you know, I only clean mine once a year because I don't have it overcrowded. It's a sand floor and it just doesn't get that dirty, really. I let them out to free range, and I just, whatever your needs are though, look in there. If it looks dirty, keep it clean. Whatever that interval is for you. If it's once a week, great, once a week. If it's once every 6 months, because you only have a few chickens in a big hen house, no problems. So make sure you do that. The second thing is, what I like to do is have the food, some kind of food in the hen house. So whatever that might be, just to make sure they have enough. You can do the pellets or whatever. And then the other foods, I throw in the run so they can scratch around and have
a
more.
So they're not just sitting there like they're on their chicken sofa eating all
like
day. They have to walk around to get it.
Yeah, they gotta, and that's their natural behavior. They like to do that. So people that just hang the food inside the hen house, you go over there and the chickens look so bored. I'm like, they're not happy like that. They want to pick around, scratch around. So throw a little something out there. A lot of people will say, oh, but the squirrels get it. Yeah, they do. Squirrels, Cardinals love to get in there, crows. I'll look out there and it cracks me up because there'll be my chickens, crows, squirrels, and cardinals.
Rabbits.
All around my chickens in the hen house. They all get along.
You're feeding the whole forest.
I'm like, okay, so maybe I need to put a little bit less so hopefully the chickens eat it. The funny thing is the chickens don't seem to mind the company at all. They're just like, yeah, whatever, my friends are over. So it's not really a problem. But it still gives the hens something to do. They just walk around out there and sometimes they'll get a little ornery and like chase the crow away or something. So make sure you put a little bit in the run for them. So if you cover all these bases, keep it going. You can't just do it once a month and just be like, oh, it's good. You got to keep on it. Keep it going. You will have fantastic egg production. You'll be like, yeah, other people will be moaning and groaning how their chickens don't lay eggs and what's wrong with them. And then, of course, you'll have a chance to teach them because you'll be going like, oh, my chickens lay eggs nonstop. I get great production. So that's what we have to do. Just like keep that ball rolling and help as many people as we can. So I hope you enjoyed this. You can click the links below and it'll show you the different videos I've talked about, the deworming, and what was the other one I talked about?
How a chicken makes an egg.
Oh yeah, those two are great. The deworming and how a chicken makes an egg. So we'll put those videos in the link so you can just watch those. If you'd like to learn more about chickens, I've put all the information into one book. So you don't have to be like looking for the information. You can just find it and flip through and get the information you need quick. And you can buy my book, Becky's Guide to Raising Backyard Chickens, by clicking the link below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.